So once the IT department generated the ID for editor, then the ball comes to the editor code. Then editor has to create a journal, configure initial settings, and upload all necessary information of journal and managing the publication process. So to get you familiar with this OJS, I created one of the link in which you can just get used to the some of the features of OJS. I already created one admin and password for you. And as I told you that OJS is always installed on some of the website. So once you will create normal OJS, then actually normal OJS will be installed on normal website. For practice purpose, this is one of my website, and I installed OJS in my website and then generated this link. So you need to simply copy this link and paste here. So this will ask you the ID and password. So I already give you the ID and password for administrator. So admin and ABC Pakistan 123. So once you log in, this is the screen which first time you will see. So here you can see the create journal. In create journal, click create journal, and you can write the journal title. It will ask a journal title, journal abbreviations, and journal descriptions. And these are the languages which are available, and you can use any language you like. Most of the common language is English. So for practice purpose, for demonstration purpose, this is one of the journal of NAMAL, which is journal of in critical inquiry. So I'll simply write NAMAL Journal of Critical Inquiry. I will write, this is the journal which is in manual way. So I will shift this journal into OJS. And stay with me, it will take just 10 minutes or 15-12 minutes to shift this all journal descriptions into OJS. So simply copy this title and then write here, paste here, journal title. What is journal initial? JCI. Journal abbreviation JCI, which is journal critical inquiry. It can be anything. And journal descriptions. So again, journal descriptions is already there. I just copy, and then I'll paste here. Okay. And this is the path. In path, actually, it can be any A, B, C, D. So I just simply write JCI because it will easier for viewers. It will be easier for editor to remember the link because JCI will indicate it's related to Journal of Critical Inquiry. So JCI, I just write the path and everything looks good, and simply press the save button. Once you save, then journal will be created on OJS. So this is the first step, and so far everything looks easy, and I'm sure that the other stages are even easier. I don't know why it takes time, but okay, once it's safe, now it is asked setting wizard. In setting wizards, this is the initial information we already gave, and this is appearance. Click on appearance tab, and these are the theme, how you want your journals to look like. So default theme, and then these are the choose a color for the headers. So what kind of color you like, this like in the left side screen, right side screen, these are called headers. So if you see this, for example, NAMAL website, this is called header, which is look like a black color. So it's up to you what kind of color you like. You can play with the colors, simply save it, and you can see how your journal look like. So you can change anytime and simply press save. We'll see. Okay, I will press save, and then I will also see what kind of languages. These are the languages. If you want to disable any of the languages, if you think that these languages are not used anymore, you can uncheck it. Okay, it's up to you. And then search indexes, so far we'll leave the search indexes. Right now I just am telling you how you can make your journal for primary settings. And these are the plugins. Again, these are some of the advanced features which you may be needed. I'll make a separate video for plugins. And in plugins, there are so many very, very good, interesting features like word clouds, like how many viewers are came to your website and which from which country they access your website. So these are the plugins, small tools which you can download and install in this web browser. So I'll make a separate video for this, so don't worry about this. So these are the some of the initial settings. I'll click on this open journal system, click here, and some more features will come. So see, this is the in left side you have a submissions, issues, settings, users and role, tools, statistics and administration. And these are the profile which is it asks my profile. So I'll simply go to the settings. In setting there are four major things: journal, website, workflow and distribution. Let's first come to the journal setting. I'll click on journal and journal identity, journal, this is the name, this is the publication and publication detail, who is the publisher, let's say Namal. Okay, what's online ISS number? So what is the online ISS number for Journal of Inquiry? This is ISS number, simply copy here, paste. What is print ISS number? So I'll simply, what is print ISS number, this is simply copy and then paste. And journal summary, which is key information, I already mentioned. Editorial team, so if let's see in the website if we have a editorial team, this is editorial board. Okay, this is editorial board, simply copy and then advisory board, and you can simply copy and paste. By the way, when you make OGS, try to update this. This is Brigadier Muhammad Ibrahim, and I'm sure that you know that we have another. Okay, so editorial board, simply copy and then paste. And this is about description about the journal. If you have any information like about the journal, like in home, you may have like vision and scope. You can simply write copy this vision and objectives and put in about the journal section. Or if you have scope and history, do you have scope and history? Okay, simply copy these two elements and paste on the about the journal and then simply paste. In about the journals or in any section, editorial board, journal summary, you can also put the pictures as well, images as well. So for example, in editorial board, if you want to put the pictures of editor, patron-in-chief, you can do this. Simply this is image. It's simply like MS Word. These are the boxes, put the information, save it and you are done. How easy it is. So the firm was not because one error was encountered, please correct this error and try again. Let's see what is the error. This error is, this is not a valid ISCN, and when I saw it, it looked like it's not a valid because 123456. So I'll just blank it and save it. Okay, so this is save. And what else information? So this is a journal identity and this is contact. In contact, there are two major contact: principal contact and technical support contact. So in principal contact, you can like for example, in website list three, contact details, that director Sibghatullah Khan. So we'll simply copy name here. Sorry. And then this is email. Simply paste phone number, blah blah blah, animation, affiliation number, mailing address, and this is the mailing address. Okay, and this is a technical support contact. Just if you have any assistant, if you have a editorial member or staff, you can write his name or her name as well. So simply like for example, ABC Sajid. Okay, email, phone number. Okay, so here technical support, just if someone has any issue on browsing, net issues, then you can contact this technical person. So this principal contact is related to the academic or journal related, and this is related to the technical things. I'll simply save it. And then what else we have? Sections. Sections, like actually there are some journals which does not only ask for articles, but they also ask for the other things like data, graphs, reviews. So mainly we NAML all journals ask for the article, so will stay as it is. So these are the basic informations we put about the journals, and again we'll go to the settings and we'll go to the website. Now in journal we did those settings in website. This is the setting for the website. In website setting, go to the setup. In setup you can put the logo here. Now it's up to you, you want to put the logo of NAML, or if you have a specific logo for this journal you can also put. So for the sake of example, I'll simply put the logo of NAML. So I'll simply, this is save, this is logo NAML, and then I'll go here, upload file, which is logo NAML, which I just downloaded, and then logo NAML uploaded. Okay, alternative if you want you can do it. And then journal thumbnail means small pictures how your journals look like. This is actually, this image is journal thumbnail. So I'll simply save image, okay, and then go to the journal thumbnail and then simply upload those file AA, and you're done. So this is journal thumbnail. Journal homepage image means that when someone opened, like someone opened, do you want any image to be shown here? You can simply put this image as well. So it will be a journal thumbnail as well as this image will also be available in journal homepage. Okay, and page footer. Do you want to put anything on the footer side? Like this is a website and this is footer. So in footer you can either copy this thing or copy this thing, or you can simply write published by Department of blah 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 blah, yeah, Department of XYZ and Faculty of WXY and National University of Modern Languages. Forgive me if you find any spelling wrong, misname. And these are the footer side, page footer. And if you want to put the image, let's say, well, I want to put the image, upload, and I want to put the image of NAML logo. So NAML logo will be appear not only on the top but also in the downside. So this is how you can put also image, and image can be anything. Even if you want to put the image of picture of rector, you can also put the rector image here and then simply write the text. Okay, and then that's it, we are done. And if you want more advanced things, there are the advanced options. In advanced options there are some additional content if you want to put here, like anything inter here will appear on your home page. So just simply do write it anything and see how your journal look like. So I'm just writing the random words and we'll see how it look like. So I think we are good so far. Okay, and then I'll just simply save it, and I want to see, view the site. This is the view site, if you see the mouse icon, view site, and we'll see how our website look like. Now this is how our website OGS look like. NAML of journal critical inquiry archive about, and look like that we missed the home page content, but this is how our OGS look like. I'll go back again, and if you want to change the menu you can also do those. Like I guess that I did not save those things. So logo NAML logo, journal thumbnail, this is AA, this is AA, and if you want to put any information you can put published by NAML, and you can put the image if you want to, and put, let's say, NAML logo. Okay, now in theme, these are the theme, these are the advances, additional things here. So I'll simply copy this scope history, these information here, because it's asked anything interesting will appear on your homepage. So put information here that you want your viewer to see. So I also put the descriptions here because it is one of the key information that any viewer should see. And you can adjust the font style, font color, or bold italic. I'm sure that you know those things. Simply save it. Okay, the appearance settings have been updated. So I'll simply see how it looks like. So I'll just make another browser in view side. So see how these journals look like. And if you see, this is the current archive in about. In about, there's about the journal, submission, a tutorial about privacy statement, contact. When you click on about the journal, this is about the journal, which an objective, scope, and history will come. And you can also put the images as well. And these in setups, there are some other features like a description for reader, for author. By default, this information is mentioned. Navigation, this is very, very important. Navigation means how you want your menu to look like. Like for by default, if you see this, there are three menus: current, archive, and about. Within about, there are four things. So if you see, this is register, login, and admin. These are the two major categories. One is primary, other is user. Primary means being editor, how you want the menu look like. User means how you want authors to see your website. So let's say primary. In primary, when you click, these are view profile information are under the admin. You can like I just simply announcement, click on announcement and drag here. Privacy statement, drag here. Contact, drag here. Submissions, drag here. Okay, and users. So simply these are the unassigned menu, these are the assigned menu. Simply copy, drag and drag here. So and save it. Okay, and we are done. And these are the languages information. What is one of the there, you can also put the buttons as well. So in settings, there are, as I told you, four things: journal and website. In journal, you can make settings about according to journals, context, section, category, must head. And in settings, in website setting, you can make changes how your website or web page of OJS should look like. Show the homepage image as the header of the background. Show the general summary on the homepage. I forgot to check those two buttons, so that's why it is like so. Okay, save, and then I'll see more options. General thumbnail, normal logo, AA. I would suggest you to please play those with those options. Nothing will harm you, nothing will harm the system. These are the free tools. I gave you a link and ID, so you can play with those options. So okay, and this is the, I will simply enter it or refresh it, then you will see that this is how your OJS look like. You can also put the image about the journals, and this is archive about. So this is actually a short brief video, and when you play those numbers, simply see how it look like, then you will unlearn so many new things. And you will notice that in order to shift your journals into OJS does not require any IT based skills. It's simply doing a copy paste or simply putting text from web page or from your MS Word file and paste here. So and everything is already built in. You just need to play with the keyboard and mouse. That's it. No programming skill is required. So I hope that you got this basic information about OJS. please play with those system, get familiar yourself, because the if you want to convert your channel into OJS, then you will be the key person to manage it. And let me know if you have any question. I will be happy to assist you. Thank you so much.